quite a interesting little situation we've got going on in Kenya at the moment. We've got guards on the gate. The reason for that is that the villages that we're located amongst at the moment, bizarrely, are fighting each other. There's a dispute going on. There have been people being killed, disputes over cattle and stuff like that. But they've agreed to not retaliate until we leave, because both villages benefit from us being here, because obviously we're employing people to help with food and transport and stuff like that. So they've agreed to stop killing each other for the moment while we're here.
Ow. In First Man Out, I've been able to go up against the best of the best in the ultimate survival race. And there's a good chance things would have gone badly sideways without all the experts behind the scenes.
Gordon now is a bit of a pest. Ed did for 2 years. And that's why he was the first person to walk the Amazon.
Four continents, 18 bone-breaking environments, and amazingly, I can walk away from all. Racing in the time of the COVID-19 pandemic and navigating between lockdowns and quarantines has been an adventure all of its own.
72 sets to go.
And yet our third and final season is our most ambitious ever. The locations are more extreme, and our survival challenges are tougher. The filming is a race against complex logistics, ever-changing traveling regulations, crazy health and safety challenges, and some of the world's most challenging terrains.
There seems to be a passage going down and into a pool. This is making me feel very nervous.
This is a different take on those races. This time, we go behind the scenes to see just what it takes to survive, thrive, and make First Man Out.
This is episode 6 of season 3, which means it's actually episode 18. And I think doing 18 survival challenges in a short space of time actually does take its toll. I've learned a huge amount. I definitely have learned a huge amount. But I think also I've recognised that physically I'm exhausted. Mentally I'm ready to put a lid on this competition as it stands as well. I think if in 18 competitions against the top survival experts in the world you can't learn what you're setting out to learn about yourself, you can't evolve in the way that you are hoping that you would, then I don't think it's ever going to happen. I think there's a window of opportunity for an experiment like this, and I think that window is starting to close.
Even though I've yet to complete this last race of season 3, I now realise that this has been a huge journey for me. Of course, I've learned a huge amount about survival. It's also been one that's changed my whole perspective on life. It all started in my first race of First Man Out in the mountains and dense rainforest of Southeast Asia, with the fearsome Golden Triangle. This is the beginning of an experiment where I'll put myself into circumstances where I don't have all the answers.
Okay, in this brand new series, First Man Out, I have Joe with me. He's gonna be literally on my shoulder the whole time, and with a much, much bigger camera than I've got, so that we can film this whole thing in 4K. Looking forward to lugging that through the trees, Joe.
It sounded like a good idea when we were sat back home, but now I'm here, seeing the terrain, seeing what we've got to get through. I don't know. Yeah, it's gonna be tough, especially keeping up with you, mate.
I don't know about that, mate. I'm 42. This entire project has been filmed in 4K, which means that we've got a lot bigger cameras than normal, and even the little camera that I'm recording this on is heavier. So as I'm holding it at arm's length in order to self-film, it just means that everything's heavier. Batteries last a shorter time, so again, it's all limitations that we've got to overcome for this shoot.
I think I'm not a prepper. I'm not learning about survival skills in order to prepare myself for Armageddon. That's not what this is about for me. For me, challenges like being put in a survival situation in the desert is because I'm learning about myself. I'm developing the ability to deal with uncomfortable situations. And actually, it's far more about everyday life. And it's about how I deal with situations. It's how I react under pressure. And it's about being a more rounded human being.
Guys, welcome to Northern Thailand. If you didn't already know, you're in the heart of the Golden Triangle.
The very concept of First Man Out was, if I put myself up against somebody else, not only am I having to face the mental battle of putting my reputation on the line and potentially getting beaten.
EJ, I've set myself a challenge to test myself against the world's best. I 100% respect your survival skills. Thank you for coming out.
I got mad respect for you, Ed. I'm honored for the invite.
I've also got to up my ante in terms of the time pressures that I've now got on myself.
EJ, your start point.
Best of luck to you.
I think in life it's really important to keep pushing yourself.
Hey, this is you.
Thanks, Woody.
The First Man Out series has evolved over the years. Filming part of season 3 in Kenya became the largest production team we've ever had. Because the challenges here run on a much deeper level. In a place that's arguably one of the most hostile environments we'll ever attempt to film in. Before the race begins, a thorough preparation period is absolutely critical.
I can see point in the distance.
On the face of it, what you watch on TV is two people racing crossing an environment.
These guys have hardly taken a break. They're really pushing it.
But in order to create that, you've probably got 40 people on the ground, both local fixers, drivers, all sorts of things. You've got a whole crew and the logistics of moving them all around. It's a big operation, actually. And then obviously, physically on the ground in terms of, I've got a cameraman with me.
This is slowing me down. No end.
My opponent's got a cameraman with them. They all need logistically supporting as well, so it is a big old operation. And, you know, without a very slick crew, without having the right people around who know how to sort and organise this sort of thing, it would all fall apart.
Once the initial team is on location, the first task is to determine the race route.
Sometimes recces don't go as planned. We have a lot of ground to cover, we have a lot to do, a lot to figure out. We have a doctor on site, but instead, he's delivering a baby in the village over there. So we had to wait for the baby. What to do? I love the fact that at the end of this, we might not have a route for Ed or the Wild Twins, but hopefully we'll have a baby. Our first production baby. Woohoo! First man out.
Recceing the environment in advance will provide an insight into locations. This is where all First Man Out course architects play a vital role in the production, from setting out the route to the safety of everybody involved. Your injuries are just part of the adventure, even for the guy who's meant to be keeping you safe.
What's happening, Woody?
We're coming through an obstacle back here that's got loads of barbed wire going through the bushes and what have you. Bank gave away, I fell, and as I fell, my finger hooked on a piece of barbed wire that's ripped up through my pinky. Exactly the same thing could happen to these guys in the jungle. They fall, their bamboo, you know, snapped everywhere. The natural reaction when you fall or slip is to grab something. They grab, they're going to cut through their palms and their hands, and they're going to end up with a similar injury to that.
Do you think you'll live?
He might live, yeah.
Had to be Woody, didn't it? Mr. Safety.
What film? Oh, that! Yeah, that's fine.